Tunes with a few embellishments. So I'd like to show you. Start off with the basic Neon Moon rhythm, which it's all over the net, but we've run through it anyway. The chords are A, D, and of course E. So starting in the A position, very repetitious pattern. Going to bar the first. But four strings on the second fret to give us our A. And you'll need to use finger and thumb or hybrid picking for this, really, whichever takes your fancy. So on the A, the sequence is we start off, all these are muted. We mute with the right hand, the fifth string open, which is our A. Then we go down to the third string, which we've already got barred. Then we'll come into the fourth string at the fourth. Then back to the third string twice. Back to the fourth string at the fourth. Take the finger off, leave the fourth string in your bar. Back down on the fourth. D, we simply drop this finger down to cover the bottom three strings, put your next finger on the second string, and we repeat the same pattern, but started on the D string on our fourth string. Fourth string, down to the second, to the third, second, third string, same pattern, just drop down. And for the E, we're just going to move up the bar from the fifth string, and we'll start our pattern on the sixth string. That's the sixth to the fourth to the fifth. Very simple. But what I really like about this is the embellishments. I signed up to learn country guitar with a guy called Ken Carlson. I'll put the link in the description. But runs this guitar course, Country Chops. I tried to learn country before. Tried a few various different courses, didn't really get on with them too deep too quickly. But with Ken, this is aimed specifically at rhythm playing. Starts off with very simple train beat rhythms up to boogies and cha-chas, very step by step. And this is where I got these transitions from for the Neon Moon. Put them all together and chopped up a MIDI track a little to add part of the transition sequence onto the solo, which I think really makes it. And that's what we turn out with. So let me run through the basic Neon Moon. Now what I'm doing here is on the A, I'm also double will stop in this second string and let it ring out a little. Mute it on the first time round. Then double stop it. Give it a little bit more body. The same in the D. The double stop the first and second here and there. The E, I just play standard. But, right, now we've got our basic pattern. Let's have a look at a verse and a chorus. There's a couple of little runs. First one is only appears once in the first round. But let's see how we go. First little run comes in on my whole world turns blue. After the D, the whole world turns back to the A for blue. So we do three steps on our sequence. Then we come to the fifth string open. Fifth string, second, third, fourth. Then we're back in our A and our third string. Continue our sequence. It's the only time that particular run appears. When the sun goes down on my side of town, that blows on my field, comes to my door, the whole world turns blue. There's a rundown bar across the river track, comes in. Second run, which is coming up to the chorus. I spend most every night, of a neon blue. Fifth string, open, fifth string, second, third, fourth. Coming up to our chorus on the D. If you lose your one and slide it up two frets of the E, only, then we're gonna pick on the first string, 4-5-4-2-4 on the frets. If you lose your one and only, you'll always room here for the lonely. She dreams in a banner of beams of a back to the A. That's our two little runs, nice and simple. So let's look at these embellishments. Pop them in here and there, wherever to you want to.
Okay, leave let's have a look at the
transitions, which we can put in here and there, sprinkle around. Our first transition is going from the A to the D.
So as we're
in our sequence here, we do three plucks of the sequence. Then we're going to double stop the second and third strings on the third and fourth frets respectively, and slide them up to the fifth and sixth respectively. You can pluck that or just do the slide, it doesn't really matter. That takes us up to our D. Instead of doing the two rounds, normally two rounds, we're going to do one round, another three from the sequence, then we're going to double stop the first and second at the fifth and seventh respectively. Come down to the fifth and third, and down to the second and third. Back to our A. The first transition we did. Now we're going to hammer on. In our A, we're going to put the second and third, hammer it on at number fourth, back to the number bar. We're going to walk it down on the fourth, fifth, down to the E, open E. Then we're going to double stop on the third string, first fret, fifth string, second fret. Slide it up, third string, second fret, fifth string, fourth fret. And then again, third string, fourth fret, fifth string, fifth fret. To second string on the fifth, third string on the fourth, then first string on the fourth, second string on the fifth, then we're going to double stop the first on the fifth and second on the seventh and slide that down two frets. So starting with our low E, back to our ordinary A. You stop them in here, there, wherever you fancy. So we get something like. When the sun goes down, on my side and also slip it in where you please. Now I like to save this E sequence to put on the end of the solo. I've chopped up the MIDI track to give the extra the extra chords to drop that in on the solo. Let me see if I can find this place on the track and play it for you. Let's just have a quick look at the solo. Okay, the solo comes out of the A. We're going to start off on the 4th string, on the 4th fret, down to the 3rd fret, which is sequence anyway. So 4th to 2nd, then we're going to drop down to our 3rd string on the 4th, and we're going to bend that up and pluck the 2nd string. Start to go through the sequence again, the 4th. Then we're going to double stop the 2nd and 3rd string on the 5th and 6th. Slide it down to the 8th, 10th, 12th. So then the 1st and 2nd string, 1st and 2nd string at the 10th, then bar the 3rd and 4th at the 12th, then the 2nd and 3rd at the 10th, I'll have to put a little hammer on onto that 3rd string, hammering onto the 11th fret. Is the 2nd string on the 10th and the 3rd string on the 9th. So then we got another bend coming down for our A position. We're going to double stop the 2nd string on the 5th, the 3rd string on the 4th, but we're going to bend it up, let it come back down, then we're back to our A bar position with the 3rd string. Just walk down 4-2-4-2 on the 4th and 5th strings. You can double stop those if you like, down to the open E. Then that's our transition in, the 4th and 5th strings on the 1st and 2nd, slide it down 4th and 5th on the 2nd and 4th, the 4th and 5th, 2nd and 3rd string on the 5th and 4th respectively, 1st and 2nd on the 4th and 5th, slide it down 5th and 7th. it's perhaps not the best of explanations, but I figure you've got it from there. The reworked MIDI backing track will be available for download on my Google page, and I'll put up the lyric sheet indicating where the runs come in, and I'll also put links in for resources where I got the little runs from, and you can go through it and pick it up yourself. At I just like these extra embellishments, makes it a bit more interesting, especially if you don't have a keyboard player. If there's only the three of you, I figure that the extra double stop in a sequence brings it to life a bit. Do that with no keys. I'll put the track up without keys and with keys. Anyway, that's it for me. Don't forget to have a look at Ken Carlson's site. Got some great stuff up there, some really, really good stuff for the beginners like me, from Simple Train Beats, Johnny Cash, how to incorporate some octave walk-ups and things, and just a new sort of perspective on the way I've been playing things, boogie rhythms, etc., countryfying them, simple little tricks, but makes a world of difference. I really recommend taking a look at Ken's site. I'll put a link in the description. Okay, that's it from me for a while, because the chemo's not going that great, and I'll have the op soon, and hopefully I'll be able to get back on guitar and see you guys again. So, thanks for watching.